With the recent rise in popularity of electric vehicles, there's been a lot of conversation, and unfortunately a lot of confusion, misunderstanding, and downright misinformation about the tires that you should use on your EV. At Tire Rack, we always want to help educate and provide answers that are factual and backed by actual test data. In order to do that, we recently added Tesla Model 3s to our fleet of test vehicles. We've already done a lot of tire testing with them to build our knowledge base so that we can provide real answers to the hard questions. So, what is an EV tire? Or are there specific tires for EVs? There are a lot of layers to that question, but at the most basic level, any tire, as long as it meets the load, speed, pressure, and size requirements of the vehicle, can be installed on an EV. And while that's good to know, it doesn't tell the whole story. So starting at sort of the ground floor of EV tires, you have original equipment, or OE EV tires. These are the tires that were installed on a given EV at the factory when it was new, and they've been developed specifically for that application. They often use efficiency-focused compounds and lower molded tread depths to maximize vehicle range. Most of the time, they'll have a layer of sound-absorbing foam adhered to the inner liner to limit certain frequencies that make their way into the structure of the vehicle, since EVs don't have the noise and vibration of an internal combustion engine to mask those things. A lot of times, even the internal construction is different. It may feature more robust materials or increased lateral stiffness to handle the force of the vehicle's mass. And when the application calls for it, some EV tires actually have a higher load range than other tires of the same size just to perform the act of carrying the weight of the vehicle. There are also tires that aren't OE on a specific EV, but they were designed from the ground up for EV applications. Some of those tires even go through steps that are similar to OE development, where each size is tuned with a specific EV application in mind. These types of EV tires generally use a lot of the same strategies and materials as OE EV tires. But since they're not original equipment, the tire manufacturers get to choose what performance goals they want to hit, instead of those things being dictated to them by the vehicle manufacturers. So they may make gains in one attribute that the tire manufacturer thinks is more important to drivers and place less emphasis on something they feel isn't as high a priority. Other tires are sort of a hybrid design. The tire manufacturer may take an existing product and make changes to it for EV use. Maybe they add foam to the inner liner or change the tread pattern to focus more on noise reduction. They might even modify the internal construction or use a different, lower rolling resistance compound. All of these changes have trade-offs, that give and take that's always present in tire design. So the tire manufacturer could do all of those things, or any combination of those things. Or they might not modify their tires at all to make them EV capable. And that brings us to our last option, and also right back to where we started. Any tire that meets the load, speed, pressure, and size requirements of the vehicle can be installed on an EV. The attributes, the characteristics, the heart and soul that make a tire a good tire don't change based on the method of propulsion of the vehicle they're installed on. Whether it's an internal combustion engine or an EV, drivers need confident traction in dry, wet, and wintry conditions. They want satisfying ride quality and noise comfort. They want efficiency, and they want at least reasonable tread life. All tires have to balance those demands, and some are better at it than others. As a real-world illustration of what we're talking about, one of the top tire manufacturers in the world recently made a public statement that all of their tires are EV-ready and are designed to be put on an electric vehicle. Their tires are used as original equipment on some of the biggest names in the EV world, so they definitely know what they're doing, and they've specifically chosen not to add a new EV-focused line to their portfolio. Will my EV lose range if I switch to non-EV tires? We've tested it. We've compared the OE tires on our EV test cars to other EV-focused tires, to performance tires, touring tires, winter tires, and while you might lose range, you also might not. So let's talk about some of the reasons that you could possibly see a decrease in your EV's range. The first is just switching from one tire model to another. Different models of tires have differing rolling resistance, which is the force, and therefore the energy, required simply to keep the tires moving. It's different from one tire to another, and that affects the potential range of an electric vehicle, or any vehicle, really. In our testing, we've generally found that the OE tires offer the best range on our EVs. Of course, there will be exceptions, and some tires have sort of been within the noise of a percentage or two one way or another in terms of efficiency, but if range is your primary concern, the OE tire is a pretty safe bet. We've found EV-focused tires that were less efficient than general replacement market tires, and some that were just as efficient as the OE tires. So simply because a tire is marketed toward EVs doesn't guarantee it will deliver more range than a tire that isn't. The biggest difference we've found so far when comparing efficiency between tires was a little bit more than an 11% drop in calculated range between a new set of OE tires and a new set of replacement market tires. That was a 34-mile reduction in our calculated range for a full charge just from installing a different set of tires. But also, you need to keep in mind, the replacement market tires had significantly higher traction in the dry, the wet, on the ice, and in the snow. Now, if you're paying close attention, you may have noticed I specifically mentioned we compared new tires. There's a reason for that, and it brings us to our next variable that affects range, and that's wear. As tires wear from use, their mass is reduced. There's less energy loss from movement of the tread blocks in the contact patch, and there's a slight hardening effect of the compound from age, heat cycles, and the slight compression of the rubber. All of those things reduce rolling resistance, so tires actually get more efficient over time as they wear. That means tires are at their most efficient, and therefore providing the longest range when they're worn out and ready to be replaced. So it's not uncommon to see a noticeable drop in range when switching from worn-out tires to brand new ones, even if you replace your existing tires with an identical set. In our testing, we've seen as much as a 27-mile difference in range between a set of tires at the wear bars and a brand new set of the same tires. Also, it's important to keep in mind these factors are additive, so they combine. That means if someone's been driving on worn-out, high-efficiency original equipment tires, and they replace them with a more traction-focused, higher rolling resistance set of tires, they could experience a drop in range of maybe 15 to 20%. It could be less than that, but it could be even more. Of course, the important thing to remember is that in that same scenario, the driver may have lost some range, but there was a huge improvement made in traction, and therefore safety, in wet or snowy conditions. And speaking of wet and snowy conditions, that brings us to our next factor that influences range, the weather. Some of the situations that have an impact are pretty obvious. If it's cold outside and you're running the heated seats, the heated steering wheel, and the climate control heat, those things all require power, and that hurts battery life. Similarly, if it's a hot day and you have the AC running, you're losing efficiency. If you have the climate control set to auto, the car will have to work harder to maintain your set temperature on a sunny day than on a cloudy day because of the added sun load. Rainy conditions will reduce your range. In addition to the possibility of strong winds that often accompany rain, even on a calm rainy day, your tires are actually pushing through the water on the road, which requires more energy. We've seen a 27-mile drop in calculated range when driving the same set of tires in rainy conditions compared to in the dry. Something that really has a tendency to throw people off is that there doesn't even have to be rain or snow on the ground to hurt efficiency. It could be perfectly clear, but if it's cold, you're going to lose range. We tested the OE tires on a 36-degree day, and our calculated range was 235 miles. With the exact same set of tires on a 61-degree day, our range was 292 miles. On a 71-degree day, the range was essentially the same at 291 miles. So that's a 57-mile drop in range just due to temperature changes. That's way more than we've seen as a result of switching from one brand or one model of tire to another. And of course, around the same time the temperature is dropping, is when a lot of people are buying new tires or switching to their winter tires to get ready for the season ahead. So they'll see this big reduction in range and automatically attribute that to their new tires. Like we discussed earlier, the tires absolutely may be a contributing factor, but the change in weather is likely the biggest influence. We've done a handful of tests comparing dedicated winter tires to the OE Tesla tires. And the winter tires actually match the efficiency of the OE tires in freezing temperatures. In warmer conditions, the OE tires provide a better range than the winter tires, but that's okay because you shouldn't use winter tires in warm conditions anyway. And admittedly, our tests use premium studless ice and snow winter tires. Something from a lower tier or in a different winter category may not be as efficient. As they say, your mileage or your range may vary. And despite what's often touted in the media or by tire manufacturers, on EV forums and anywhere else you may look, range isn't the end-all, be-all of EV tire traits, especially when you consider what else you might be giving up. Do EV tires have lower traction than non-EV tires? While it's not a guarantee, there's a good possibility that an EV-focused tire will have less traction in at least some conditions than an equivalent non-EV-focused tire. There are always compromises in tire manufacturing, and one of those classic trade-offs is between rolling resistance and traction. And that can mean dry traction, wet traction, or snow and ice. A lot of the strategies tire manufacturers use to reduce rolling resistance, therefore making the tire more efficient and improving vehicle range, will have a negative impact on traction. Some tires, and some tire manufacturers, do a better job of managing and limiting those compromises than others. So you could absolutely have a tire from a premium manufacturer that's both more efficient and has better traction than a tire from a company with less technological know-how. But if you were to somehow take an existing tire design and just say, okay, now increase the efficiency, you're likely going to decrease traction in one or more situations. Do EV tires wear out faster than non-EV tires? This one's another yes and no question. EVs, by their very nature, tend to wear tires faster than a comparable internal combustion engine vehicle. So it's not that EV tires automatically wear faster than non-EV tires, it's that tires wear faster when they're installed on an EV. Of course, there are lots of factors that contribute to tire wear, but 20% less wear life on an EV versus an internal combustion engine vehicle is the commonly quoted figure in the tire industry. You might do better, or you might do worse, but the added weight of an EV, plus the nearly instant torque, plus the potential change in driving habits as you get used to all that torque, all those factors contribute to faster wear. Tire manufacturers are constantly working to improve tire life in these applications, but also remember there are trade-offs in tire design. And if you have a tire that's hyper-focused on efficiency, and therefore range, it might sacrifice wear, among other desirable characteristics. What should I look for in an EV tire? Honestly, that's the same answer that we would give for the driver of any kind of vehicle, and it's the reason why we test. We want to analyze all aspects of the way a tire performs so you can find the right tire for you based on what you drive and how you drive and where you drive. Our testing supports what some major tire manufacturers are saying, that just because you drive an EV doesn't mean you have to put an EV-specific tire on your vehicle. All tire design involves compromise, and every tire offers a different blend of traits or characteristics. If you drive an EV-focused tire may deliver the performance you're looking for, but it's not guaranteed. EV tires are ultimately just another option in a huge realm of possibilities, and traction-related attributes may be secondary concerns for an EV tire, where efficiency, noise attenuation, and improved longevity might be more important than other characteristics. It's possible a more broad market replacement tire will best suit your needs. Or maybe the best choice for you is the OE tire for your EV. Tire Rack is here to help you make those decisions. You can check out our expert testing, read consumer reviews, talk to one of our sales specialists, or use our online tire decision guide to help you find the right tire for you. We really hope this video helps answer questions and clear up a lot of the lingering uncertainty that you may have. We're going to continue with our EV testing, building our database of EV tire performance and efficiency data, and we're going to keep creating more EV-focused videos. We want to hear from you if there's any specific EV-focused testing you'd like to see, or if there are questions we didn't answer here. So if there are, leave it in the comments section, And if you want to see more test videos like this one, be sure to like and subscribe.